throw your diamonds in the... What is up, YouTube family? In this video, if you're in the UK and you're trying to make a Sainsbury's run, or if you are in the United States and you need to go and make a Walmart run on your cut, this video is for you. And what you guys see me first get here is always get mixed veggies, because this is the way I get my micros in. And they're high volume for low carbohydrates. So if you're low on carbs, get mixed veggies, because they help you out when you're hungry. Mix the mixed veggies in with your tortilla wrap or whatever food you're having. And another way to get my micros in is by getting frozen fruits. Frozen fruits are generally lower in carbohydrates compared to any other food. So I always get strawberries or raspberries and I mix them in and blend them in with my shake. And the next thing we're going for here is cheese. Now this cheese is high in protein and low in fat. You always want to have a look at the labels before you shop. And what I've done before I ever go shopping, I write a list of what I need, and that's what I stick to, and I don't get anything else. This shopping actually took me 16 minutes to do because I know exactly what I'm gonna get. So write down a list of what you're gonna get and don't buy anything else. Be disciplined about it, because it's so hard walking past that packet of Oreos. And the next thing we're getting here is ham, and I love this ham because it's 15 grams of protein per 100 grams, and normally when you have a slice or two they come to 35 grams, and that's almost nothing. And the next thing, we're in the dairy section, and this is routine for me. So what I've gone to doing is using Greek yogurt, and like I was telling you guys before, I normally blend them in with the frozen fruits that I get. And these Greek yogurts are high in protein and they're lower in carbs and fats compared to the other yogurts you can get. So they're high in volume but they're low calorically dense and they're good for you. I absolutely love these. And I get these now. These I get as my snack. Now these are more calorically dense, and you see how small they are compared to the bigger ones I showed you, the Greek yogurts. But that's for my snack, and it works for me. So you guys can see a direct example of what decisions you can make to get more food in, but you can make different substitutions so you're clever about your calories. And I'm just showing you another example of the snack that I get, which is those yogurts, and I have one of those a day as my snack, just to kill the sweet tooth. And we're moving on. Now this is when it comes to milk. I like mixing my protein shakes with my milk, but almond milk, no, I'm sorry, it's way too expensive. So what I go with is 1.5% milk, and I think that can fit anybody's calories. You don't have to pay that ridiculous amount for almond milk. And then we move on. I got 1.5%, I always get two of those. And wait, hold up, I turned back because I live in Russia. Look, there's an entire aisle just of Russian vodka. Just take a look. I thought I should just include this, as much as this is a bodybuilding channel. Russia is notoriously known for their love of vodka. But back to the video, and what we always get is eggs. Eggs is a good source of protein. I normally do 3 to 4 eggs. I keep 3 egg whites and take out the yolk. And now normally if you're living in the States and you can get carton eggs, that's a great way to do it. But Russia isn't fully macro friendly, so that's why I said this is applicable to anybody. And now we're going on to our meats. They're high protein sources, and I love ground beef, ground turkey, if you have whatever you prefer, ground beef, ground turkey, it's all the same. Whatever macros are the best. But as you guys can see, I'm always checking the packet labels. So that's about 19 grams per 100 grams with the ground beef and about 6 grams of fat. I'm pretty sure in the United States that they have higher protein content within their ground beef. But moving on, the next protein source that I get is chicken breast. I know it's old school bodybuilding, but guys, when you want to hit those macros and you need to hit that high protein that you normally do on a cut, chicken breasts are always the way. You can always be creative in the way you make it. And then we're moving on. And now this is what I'm talking about, high volume foods with low caloric density. Is this oats? And I think there's 80 grams for 100 calories, which is absolutely great. It absolutely saves me in the morning. It saves me in the morning when I'm hungry or whenever I break my fast. And another thing, guys, every bodybuilder knows it. It's old school, but rice cakes are the one. Rice cakes help me out a lot. If I need a snack or if I have a sweet tooth, this ones are actually cherry flavored, so they help me out a lot as well. And mind you, the foods I'm getting is very, very basic, so this will work for you. You will find this anywhere. And beans, I've always loved black beans. Being a Latin kid, my mom always cooks black beans, so granted that I can get them here. Black beans are great, high in fiber, high in protein, and moderate carbohydrates. I normally have 100 grams of black beans a day that I mix with my tortilla wrap. You guys have said that you wanted to see how I made that wrap, so I'll be making it in the next video. And moving on, guys, when you're cooking, and especially if you're contest prepping, then I can understand, but add some spice to your food because it changes the dynamic of a meal. So here's some barbecue sauce that I add with any of my meats that I have, and man, you always need to go with a Tabasco. Tabasco, I'm sorry if it's like a black thing, but I love Tabasco. I know everyone loves Tabasco. It doesn't have anything to do with color. And here's my tortilla wraps. Now, if you guys have noticed, I haven't gone for spaghettis. I haven't gone for rices. Normally, I'd like to have so much of those. I'd add so much rice or so much spaghetti. It's very, very easy to just be like, okay, add 100 grams of uncooked rice to your meal. So I stick to wraps because it's an easier way for me to control the amount of carbs I'm going to consume. So if I know I'm having one wrap, I'm going to have a fixed amount of carbs in that one meal. So the wrap is higher in carbs, but because I've already accounted for it in the low carb foods, that helps me a lot. And here's the whole thing, all my meals that I get. And in conclusion, all my meals cost $40 US dollars, 40 euros if in the UK, lesser than that in pounds, I'm pretty sure. And that's the end of the video, guys. If you're new to the channel, like the channel, comment, subscribe, it's much appreciated. And I'll see you guys. Shout out to everyone out there, and peace. Throw your diamonds in the